Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast, interview with the President of the Republic of Western Armenia, Armenak Abrahamian, the memory of the victims of the genocide against the Armenian people. Turkey has filed a lawsuit against Russia with the demand to return Ottoman flags. Senator Menendez calls on US government to press Azerbaijan for releasing Armenian prisoners of war. Defense Minister of Russia Shoigu, UN does not respond to request for assistance in demining Artsakh. The National Interest magazine draws parallels between Ilham Aliyev and Saddam Hussein. Let's support Western Armenia TV. On Western Armenia TV, the President of the Republic of Western Armenia, Armenak Abrahamian, spoke about the motives of the genocide against Armenians, analyzing the well-known events of that period. In particular, he described the genocide against Armenians as a human crime, noting that the genocide is not Armenian but Turkish, and if we make a mistake in interpreting the expressions, we will not be able to understand what really happened to the Armenians living in their native territories. Continuing his speech, President Abrahamian referred to the fact that who has decided that the genocide started in 1915, when in fact the state-organized Hamidian regiments crushed the Armenian population in 1894 to 1896, carrying out that policy until 1906. There are many undeniable facts about the cases mentioned before, even memorandums drawn up by different states, proving the reality of Abdulhamid's massacres. Speaking about the Second Artsakh War, the President of the Republic of Western Armenia mentioned that it was a continuation of the genocide committed against Armenians. The interview is available on our website and YouTube channel. Dear compatriots, the citizens of the Republic of Western Armenia, we present you the list of events dedicated to the commemoration of the genocide against Armenians to be held on April 24, Saturday 2021, April 24. The following events will be held with the participation of the official representatives of the Republic of Western Armenia. Paris at 11 p.m. in front of the Comitas Monument, Canada Square. Lyon at 11 p.m. commemoration in front of the memorial, Antonin Poncet Square. Marseille at 11 p.m. in front of the Mother and Her Four Sons Monument in the Memorial Park. Draginia at 5 p.m. in front of the Monument of Armenia Aleda Zemar. Mandalia at 11 p.m. commemoration in front of the Khachkar Armenia Square. Antibes at 3 p.m. commemoration in front of the Marichaux Monument, November 11 Avenue. Yerevan at 11 p.m. near the Memorial of the Genocide Against Armenians. Turkey has filed a lawsuit against Russian Federation under the Return the Honor slogan, with a demand to return Ottoman flags. As Daily Sabah reports, Umit Topal, an amateur historian and writer, filed a lawsuit on April 8 for the return of 10 military standards seized by Russians during the invasion of Turkey's eastern Karin province during World War I. The plaintiff says standards taken by invading Russian troops in 1916 represent the honor of the Turkish nation and should be returned. He claims that Karin, which was occupied a few times during the Russian Empire's Caucasus campaign targeting the Ottomans, was last taken from the Ottoman forces in February 1916. Along with 9 standards, Russian forces had taken thousands of prisoners. Topaz says the standards are currently in a depot of Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg. The government of the Republic of Western Armenia has given its assessment to the topic, which we present to you below. Let us remind that the amateur Turkish historian has raised an issue which refers entirely to the battles that took place in 1916 on the outskirts of Karin, the capital of Western Armenia. Russia recognized the right of the Armenians of Tachka, Armenia, to self-determination before their independence by a decree issued by Lenin on December 29, 1917. The Armenian Karin was returned to Turkey in 1918. We would also like to look for the documents submitted by the amateur historian to be submitted by the Turkish Ministries of Defense and Foreign Affairs and their legal basis. It should be reminded that there are also historian artifacts in the military trophy of the Russians, which belong to the Armenian people, as they represent the Armenian national culture, and the Turkish amateur historian should have no pretension towards them. During the US Senate Foreign Relations Committee confirmation hearing on Thursday, April 15, of Ambassador Victoria Nuland to serve as US Under Secretary of State for Political Affairs, SFRC Chairman Bob Menendez raised key issues relating to the Armenian people, including the Armenian prisoners of war still unjustly held captive by Azerbaijan and the need for robust humanitarian assistance. As Armenpress reports, the Armenian Assembly of America informed, Ambassador Nuland confirmed that the U.S. has to get the prisoners released. I've worked on Armenia, Azerbaijan, Nagorno-Karabakh issues for more than 25 years, and the way things went down last year was absolutely tragic for so many in the region. Nuland continued. During the afternoon hearing, Chairman Menendez also spoke about the significance and urgency of U.S. humanitarian assistance to Artsakh and the importance of ensuring that the Armenians displaced from their homes in Nagorno-Karabakh get the assistance they need. The UN did not respond to Russia's offer to participate in the demining of Artsakh. The Minister of Defense of Russia, General of the Army Sergei Shoigu, announced in the film aired on Friday on Zvezda TV channel. When all this happened in November, we applied to the UN Mine Action Center, inviting them to Artsakh. The whole area is mined. People are not able to go back there. Who came? Yet no one. The Russian Ministry of Emergency Situations, the deminers of the Ministry of Defense, as well as local deminers work there, Shoigu mentioned. The minister stressed that so far only Russian deminers work on the spot. The National Interest magazine has published an article about Azerbaijani President Ilham Aliyev and the Park Museum opened in Baku at his initiative. As Armen Press reports, the author of the article, Michael Rubin, compared Ilham Aliyev with former Iraqi President Saddam Hussein and the Park Museum of Baku with Baghdad's Victory Arch, known to locals as the Sword of Qadisiyya. Aliyev, who never served in the military, strolls around in military fatigue showing off captured Armenian equipment and wax models of Armenian soldiers before dressing assembled troops. The centerpiece of the Park of Trophies is an arch made from the helmets of killed and captured Armenian soldiers. That Azerbaijan continues to illegally hold 260 prisoners of war and kidnap civilians, some of whom he might have killed in captivity, underscores the tastelessness of the display, the article reads. Dear compatriots, the state television company of Western Armenia is not engaged in self-advertising. Our work of years aims to maintain and to develop the connection with the homeland among our compatriots. It is the duty of all of us to support our national demands in this historical period, to act together against the challenges we face, to achieve the establishment of our fair rights, which unfortunately is ignored in modern international relations. Our struggle is eternal, but its victory is indivisible. Western Armenia expects your active support on this difficult path, which we'll pass together. Together we can do more. Now we present you Los Angeles Instrumental Band. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.